So now that you know how individual UI elements are sized, let's talk about how to start arranging them together. Let's have a quick refresher on what you learnt in Android Fundamentals 1 about the core layout managers, like frame layout, linear layout, and relative layout. Now remember, a frame layout arranges the views inside it, one on top of each other, and each view can have a gravity or stretch to fill the width or height of the parent frame layout. So frame layouts are a great way to display overlapping content. A linear layout arranges its children in a single direction. For example, a vertical linear layout arranges its children from top to bottom. Linear layout is one of the most useful layouts to have in your toolbox. You can create pretty much any layout with it. Be careful though, not to over-rely on this, as another layout might actually be a more efficient way to create the desired effect. A relative layout arranges its child views relative to each other or to its bounds. So, for example, a field can align to the top left or top right or to the bottom edge of the relative layout. While relative layout can be powerful, it also has some performance implications. So be wary of using this layout, especially near the root of your hierarchy. A grid layout arranges its children in a grid. Shocker. When each child has a given row or column within that grid, they can be arranged automatically in any direction and now have a weight property in order to fill a column or row. Grid layout is a great way if you want to align content along multiple axes, such as vertically and horizontally at the same time, in a grid, which would be hard to achieve with a different nested layout manager. A scroll view is a very simple view which holds one single child that allows you to scroll its contents, either up or down. In Android Fundamentals, we also touched on List View and its newer cousins Recycler View and View Pager, and how it dynamically uses a small number of child views to present a small window into a larger collection. List View and Recycler View let you scroll through a list of items, while View Pager lets you horizontally page through individual items. To understand when to use a particular view group, let's take a look at some examples of real-world screens and talk about how you would build them. After that, we'll show you a quiz and ask you, yes, you, to apply layouts to build up a relatively complex UI.